Adventures, and today I'm going to share some information with you about buying a drink package on a Carnival cruise. So, should you do this? That's the question. Is it worth it financially? Let's figure it out. So, let's do some math, shall we? There's two different packages that you can buy on a Carnival cruise. The first one is a soda package, and that is broken out by price depending on if you're a child or an adult. So for a child, it's about $6 a day, and an adult, it's $8.50. Obviously, this is subject to change as we move forward in the future. What does the Bottomless Bubbles get you? It gets you soda and juice. Now, something to think about. If you are traveling, they have lemonade pretty much everywhere you go. There's dispensers, there's water, you know, there's other things too. There's like regular coffee, all that good stuff. So you can survive without, you know, utilizing any kind of drink package and still drink things on the ship. But if you really love soda, it's something to think about. Before you buy the Bottomless Bubbles though, do remember that when traveling on Carnival, each guest is allowed 12 cans or cartons per person to be brought on board. So for example, if you're traveling with a spouse, you and your spouse can each have a case of 12 sodas, sparkling water, any kind of non-alcoholic beverage, which might be plenty to get you through your trip, and then you can just store it in your little refrigerator in your stateroom. But if you want the Bottomless Bubbles, just try to estimate, you know, how much do you really think you're going to be drinking each day? Because the sodas, if you buy them on board, are not very expensive. They're just a few dollars. Now, obviously, they tack on a 15% gratuity on top of that. But if you're planning on drinking three or more sodas or juices a day, it might be worth it to get the Bottomless Bubbles, and then you never think about it. But if you're gonna maybe have one or two and bring some on yourself, I don't think it's worth it. I think just stick with what you have. Now, what if you wanna drink alcohol? Well, that's a different story. So they have an alcohol package where it's not just drinks, but it's also specialty coffees. So you've got your espressos, your mochas, your lattes, all that kind of stuff. And that is about $52 a day if you pre-buy it before you head out on your trip. But like being allowed to bring soda on board, you can also bring wine on board. So for each person 21 and older, you can bring one 750 milliliter, which is your standard bottle of wine, on board with you. So that may not be a lot, but who knows, maybe that's all you need. So something to think about when we're doing our math. If you bring your wine and you forget your wine opener, there's a $15 corkage fee. So what I recommend doing is getting one of those kind of old school little tiny openers. They're not the easiest, but you can just fit that in your luggage, bring the wine in the carry-on, not in your checked bag, and you can open it yourself. There's wine glasses in your stateroom, or you can get one, you can ask for one. So if you want to, if you're not a big drinker and you're fine with regular coffee, you know, maybe you don't need to purchase something that's 50 something dollars a day. The average drink, so what do drinks kind of run you? Because you can't bring beer on board, and since you can only bring one bottle of wine, something to be mindful of. Beers are around $7 each. Your specialty cocktails are gonna run you anywhere from $9 to $12 or $13, depending on what's in it, how big it is, etc. Glasses of wine are gonna be around $10 to $15 each, depending on the type of wine that you're ordering. So if you're doing the math and you're thinking, you know, I might get one or two kind of fancy coffees in the morning, and then I might have a couple of glasses of wine at dinner, it might add up. But if you order the unlimited drink package, if there's another adult staying in your room, they are automatically charged for it as well. So that's also something to think about. So for example, my husband drinks a little more than I do, but I drink way more coffee than he does. So on our last cruise, you know, we decided, because we had purchased the unlimited package before, we just didn't think about it. But, you know, on our last cruise, I thought, you know, maybe I don't drink a lot of wine, you know, not a lot of mixed drinks, stuff like that. So let's just see. So what ended up happening was for us, we did bring two bottles of red wine on board, and we got a little tiny opener for that. And I never ordered a specialty coffee, even though when I had the unlimited drink package, I got one every day. And sometimes I'd get, you know, a blended one in the afternoon too. Because I didn't have the package, I just got regular coffee. Sometimes I'd mix it with a little hot cocoa and, you know, make a little like poor person's mocha. But that was fine. And then when we totaled up our bill at the end of the trip, we spent roughly, so it was a 7-night excursion. So let's do the math right here. So it's about $52 per person. So $104 a day for 7 days. And that's if you pre-book it. If you order it on the ship, it's a little bit more. So were we going to drink with specialty coffees, sodas, mixed drinks, wine, all of that stuff, $700 worth of alcohol and soda and all the other stuff? We didn't. We didn't even come close. When we itemized our bill, not including gratuity that we added on later, we only spent about $350 for the entire week. And part of that was New Year's. They were handing out glasses of champagne that were complimentary. And because we brought our own two bottles of wine, we didn't even come close to it. But in the future, if I was going on a trip, you know, maybe with some friends and family, and it was more than just the four of us in my immediate family, I might drink a little more because, you know, put the kids club, go to the piano bar, you know, stuff like that. I might actually get up to that point, or I might treat myself with some more specialty coffees than I did on this trip. But if you are thinking about price and you're trying to be careful with where you spend your money, if you're not a big drinker, if you're not really into the sodas and stuff, or you're planning on bringing those on board with you, I would say just pay a la carte and you can save a little bit of money, analyze your bill at the end, and you'll probably come out on top. So if you have any questions or comments, please don't hesitate to put those below and subscribe to this channel for more travel tips and reviews in the future. Thank you so much.